Now, here's meteorologist Pete Mangione with your live Pinpoint Doppler 12 futurecast.
Well, things fairly quiet across most of the area right now. However, some thunderstorms actually rolling through portions of Rhode Island. You can see the cell here headed up, getting ready to clip a 295 out towards the Lincoln area, perhaps headed towards Woonsocket, Cumberland, and even on into the Attleboros over the next hour. And right now it does appear to have some pretty heavy rain, downpours, gusty winds, and of course the danger of some lightning. So just be mindful of this cell as it continues to move off to the north and the east. Let's take a look at now at your forecast for the rest of the afternoon. Hit or miss showers and thunderstorms a lot of the afternoon. It actually won't be raining. We will actually increase the threat of the showers and potentially some strong thunderstorms later on tonight through tomorrow morning. A coastal flood advisory in effect. This is for areas along Narragansett Bay, including the Rhode Island south coast. Basically, winds coming in from the south, and that will match up with high tide, which is just after 7 p.m. across most locations this evening. So the potential of some splash over, even some businesses with basements along the shore, potential of a little bit of flooding there. So something to be mindful of from 6 to 9 tonight. And things, of course, could be made worse if we combine the coastal flooding with flooding due to some rainfall, which is possible as we head into tonight with the chance of those showers increasing. Now we look in Providence right now, and you can see the gray skies. We've had some showers, downpours off and on, temperatures in the 70s already in Providence. Taunton, you're at 70 degrees, Newport 62, New Bedford 68 degrees. And right now in Newport, winds out of the southwest at 12 miles an hour. Of course, you could see stronger gusts if you happen to be under any shower or thunderstorm. Moving on now to our satellite picture, you will notice that although we do have some showers, downpours pushing through right now, the core of the moisture is still off to our west. This is associated with a center of low pressure that will start to make its way through tonight. And in fact, our computer model, our futurecast, tracks this going hour by hour, doing a very nice job. So throughout the afternoon, the chance of some scattered showers and downpours will be there. But notice it's not that widespread. Watch what happens as we go to, say, 7, 8, 9 o'clock. The green kind of fills in on the screen as the chance of some of these showers and thunderstorms increases. And then it really continues off and on, heavy at times overnight through tomorrow morning and throughout much of the day tomorrow. Unfortunately, this is Friday afternoon. Still, you could see a fair amount of moisture in the area. And it does look like the storm will actually stall, keeping some of those showers around for Saturday, even into Sunday. We'll break down that weekend forecast in just a second. This afternoon, temperatures in the 70s inland because of those winds coming in from the south will stay in the 60s for the most part at the coast. And then tonight, a fairly mild night. We're talking about temperatures generally falling only into the 60s, maybe a few upper 50s out there. And then as we head into the weekend, some more chilly mornings on the way. Notice that 46 by Sunday morning. But before we get to Sunday morning, we'll talk about the rest of the 7 days. So off and on showers tomorrow. Now on Saturday, certainly not a very nice day. It's chilly, it's cloudy, quite windy, periods of rain and drizzle. Sunday, I don't want to give the impression that Sunday will be a nice day because it won't be, but it could be a little bit better than Saturday. A little less wind, more lulls in the rain activity, and perhaps a little bit of sunshine, but there's still a question mark on that. That's why I actually intentionally put that question mark in. Now on Monday, at this point, that looks okay. We're at 67 degrees. With a mix of clouds and sun, so at least the end of the holiday weekend on Memorial Day will look okay. 73 on Tuesday and then partly cloudy on Wednesday with a temperature of 76 degrees. So unfortunately, it looks like, you know, 2/3 of the holiday weekend is not great, but the good news about holiday weekends, we get 3 days, so the third day should be okay.
Glass always half full with Pete. Thanks so much. All right, here's a look.